Good evening, everyone. We begin a busy night of news with team coverage of the flood forecast.
For many, it feels a lot like 2008, especially for the Birdland neighborhood. Alex Murphy has that story.
But first, all eyes are on Saylorville Lake, and Todd Magel is there live where the inflatable gates are now up. Todd?
Kevin and Stacy, those pneumatic gates, as they're called, the pneumatic crest gates, went up about 4 o'clock this afternoon, and we have a live look here, sort of in the dark, of what those gates look like. The air bladders raised them up about 4 this afternoon. They are now lighted here by the Army Corps. Saylorville folks are watching these as the water slowly rises behind them. Now, here is why those pneumatic crest gates went up. Normally, the Saylorville pool, or the lake level, is at 836 feet above sea level. Well, tonight, with all that flood water coming into Saylorville during the past month, the level is up to 879.5 feet. Now, the spillway here next to the dam is just 884 feet high. Why is that a big deal? Well, when you add the extra 6 feet of the pneumatic crest gates that went up this afternoon, that makes the flood level 890 feet. Now, once the water gets that high, it will go over these crest gates and head straight to the Des Moines River. Then the Corps will slowly lower the gates over about the next 12 hours, or all that rushing water would destroy those gates. Now, tonight, the prediction is the water will go over the top of the gates by Tuesday or Wednesday morning. It's all too familiar to Lake Manager Jeff Rose.
We're ready as you know, as we can be. It's really Mother Nature's call. You know, we had a rough winter. We've had over 13 inches of rain in the month of June again, which is pretty similar to what we had in 08. And we've got a lot of water that's upstream that's heading our way.
Now, here is another Google Earth perspective weather. Let's start out by showing the video from 2008. Now, this is what happened when Saylorville Lake gets so full that the water begins to go over the pneumatic crest gates. You might remember this video. The gates, of course, lower very slowly. The water heads down then the Des Moines River and goes towards the metro area. Now, let's take a look at the Google Earth perspective of the Saylorville Spillway. We put this together for you. The blue lake there, middle of the screen, moves to the top. Now, when it's full, the water slowly creeps up to the spillway where we are now, which is just to the west of the main dam that people drive over every day. And eventually, the flood water goes over the spillway. It goes over the 6-foot crest and it gathers and, of course, heads right down to the Des Moines River. And that's really what we have to keep an eye on to make sure the levees in Des Moines will hold for what could be potential flooding later this week. Kevin and Stacy.
Todd, before you go, are they predicting the same flow of water this week that we saw 2 years ago?
Not quite, and that is that's the one little bit of good news, and we asked about that today, and here's the numbers. 2 years ago, the flood water shooting out of Saylorville over this spillway and also shooting out of the main dam there that everybody sees, that big jet of water, that was at 47,000 cubic feet per second back in 2008. Well, this year, they're predicting about 43,000 cubic feet per second, so still lots of water, millions of gallons of water that has nowhere to go but toward the metro area.
At this point, we're looking for any reason to be optimistic. Todd Magel, thank you very much. All this high water means that Saylorville will be a pretty quiet place for this 4th of July holiday weekend. Construction has stopped now on the road below the dam. All beaches, boat ramps, the Bob Shetler campground, all closed and will remain closed throughout the weekend. But other campsites, most of the rest of them are open and will remain open for the holiday weekend.
We head downstream now where Birdland residents are preparing for the worst. Right now, the Des Moines River at 2nd Avenue is at 23 feet, which is flood stage. The river is expected to crest Thursday at 28.3 feet. And as News Channel 8's Alex Murphy shows us, that's the city's main area of concern.
Well, Stacy, as you might imagine, residents and businesses in the Birdland neighborhood aren't happy about the potential for flooding, and they aren't taking any chances. Instead, they're taking precautions.
With their eyes on the skies and the Des Moines River, Birdland residents are keeping close tabs on the possibility of flooding.
It looks as if we'll be in a situation probably Wednesday night or early Thursday morning when they'll reach the capacity of the reservoir and actually have to do an emergency release of water to Des Moines. That's our concern.
This month's heavy rainfall in a short amount of time is causing concern and becoming an all too common situation.
For a fourth time since 1993, I'm moving my mom out so we can get her stuff out before we're being threatened by another flood.
Charles Carter is busy reloading his mom's possessions into a moving truck. They haven't unpacked much of it since the last time they moved her in 2008.
It's the uncertainty is what's getting us, you know. If we knew it was going to flood, then fine, but we don't know, so we got to be prepared and load her up again. We shouldn't have to worry about this, you know. It's just that levee over there, and if it was fixed, we wouldn't probably worry so much.
Construction crews are back at it again, just like they were in 2008 here at the Birdland Park, building a temporary levee out of dirt. Officials say they're going to keep a close eye on this area over the next week.
A few blocks over, workers at Gold Dome Buildings put sandbags around their doors and are moving their sheds.
We're expecting somewhere between 08 and 93, so that's going to put it on this parking lot.
And all that water can take its toll on their business.
It's just a waiting game. We're out of business until that river decides to go down.
But they are weary to move permanently.
They always say if you move a business, you pretty much kill it. So we're afraid to do that too. So we're caught between a rock and a hard place.
Now, Bill Stowe says the contractors that are building the levee are from the Corps of Engineers, not the city of Des Moines. He says he shares the same frustrations as many of the residents in the Birdland neighborhood. But he says sitting around pointing fingers won't get you anywhere. Instead, he hopes for dry weather so they can move forward.
And Alex, the city of Des Moines will be meeting with neighbors and business owners tomorrow in the Birdland area, right?
That's right, Stacy. An informational meeting for Central Place businesses will be held tomorrow morning at 8:30. That's the Acme Printing Center, Printing Company, rather, and a meeting for the Birdland neighborhood is scheduled for tomorrow night at 6 at the Senior Center in Park Fair Mall.
Thank you.